You ready for some more canyon wisdom? This one can be life-changing if you really take it to heart. Every time I come to the canyon, I hear people looking at a wall like this giant 2,500-foot red wall behind me. They look at that wall and say, I can't do it. Where's the elevator? Please have a helicopter come for me. And you know what? The truth is, they can do it. Let me tell you, there is not a refugee camp down by the river full of people who climbed in but couldn't make it out. Everybody eventually makes it out. Now, it may be hard work, it might be painful, but when they do make it out, they look back and they say, I'm proud of myself, what an experience. I have earned a steak and a beer. You're stronger than you think you are. And recognizing that, realizing how strong you really are can prevent you from cheating yourself by settling for anemic dreams and goals, by settling for a lot less out of life. And I don't just mean in terms of money and things. I mean in terms of the quality, the richness of your experience of life, the spiritual journey of life. You're stronger than you think you are. You can do more than you think you can. So stop cheating yourself. And let me give you two very practical things to think about and to work on that will help you accept the fact that you've got this incredible inner strength. You know, the Bible asks this question. Who would light a candle and put a basket over it? And I know every single day my challenge is going to be taking the basket off the candle, and I know the same thing's true for you. So here's the first thing. Pay very close attention to that little inner mental voice. Mihai Csikszentmihalyi, the psychologist now in Claremont University, California, has written many books on the power of what we say to ourselves, for better or worse. He wrote a book called The Evolving Self. And in that book, he said, the human mind automatically gravitates toward negative, frightening, and depressing thoughts. I know it's true for me. When I am hiking along, I start thinking about all my worries. Do I have to pay the taxes? And how's my business going? And how are the kids doing? And pretty soon, I realize I'm draining my energy with all of these worries, all of this negative self-talk, looking at a wall like that and saying, I can't do it. And what I've actually been doing a study on this, a personal observational study. When I reprogram that self-talk from, what do I have to do now? What if this goes wrong? To how beautiful the surroundings are and how much I'm enjoying this and how much energy I have. I tell myself I have energy. I have more energy. And so that's the first thing that I really encourage you to do. Pay very close attention to that whining negative voice in the back of your head that says, I can't do this. Tell it to shut up. Say, I'm stronger than you think you are. I'm stronger than I think I am. And I'm going to prove it. And the second thing gets to that energy question. Mark Victor Hansen, the author, co-creator of Chicken Soup for the Soul, that whole phenomenon. He was at a conference I put on once. And he said, the person who has the most energy in life is going to have the greatest life. And you have more energy than you think you do. Energy is a decision. Let me illustrate. If you have the worst day of your life, you come home at the end of the day, you're exhausted, you plop down in the easy chair, you turn on the TV and you open a beer and some chocolate or whatever you do on those terrible days when you got no energy, and there's a knock on the door, and you go to the door and you open it up, and there is Ed McMahon, and there's a camera crew behind him, and he's saying, congratulations, you have just won $3 million in the sweepstakes. Now, if your response is, gee, Ed, that's really nice, but you know what? I'm awful tired. Can you come back tomorrow? By all means, go plop back on the easy chair and veg out. But if you're ready to have a party, where did that energy come from? And the truth is, it was always there. You always had that energy. You were just choosing not to tap into it. You were choosing to give in to that negative self-talk. There is a technical scientific term for this phenomenon. It's called lazy. And we all give into it on occasion. If you decide to have energy, you're going to have a much richer, much more wonderful life. By the way, if you go to my website, joetai.com, you can actually click on the button on how to have more energy, and you can download our, I think it's about 80-page report, which has 69 great ideas to have more energy. Stop beating yourself up. Stop the negative self-talk. Decide to have energy. Decide to do the things that make life enjoyable. Tell yourself, yes, I can climb that wall. It only looks high. Let me say one more thing about this wall behind me. When you stand here and you look at it, it looks like there is no way on God's green earth you're ever going to get up there without an elevator or a helicopter. And you march toward the trail, and you can only see a little bit of it at a time. And then it appears to go into a dead end. And you march toward the dead end on faith that it'll keep going, and it does. It turns around, it's a switchback, and it circles its way around. You can never see more than one or two or three switchbacks ahead of you, but you just keep marching. And then at the top, you look down behind you and you see the whole trail unfolded out there. That's a great metaphor for miracles. The miracle was not the trail. The trail was always there. The miracle was that you kept walking. You took the basket off the candle. You kept walking. Even though you weren't absolutely certain the trail could go on, you sort of knew it would. You kept walking until you got to the top, and then you look out and you can see the whole thing unfolding behind you. Very much like starting a business, raising a family, any worthwhile endeavor, it's going to be like climbing that wall. Remember, you're stronger than you think you are.